Buffalo fans, I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Ole Miss Rebels and the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Number two is one of the X factors of this basketball club who can lead them to a win tonight.
This kid is one of the best offensive threats in the country, baby. He fills it up from anywhere as well as Dishon Rock.
The Cowboys will see that their offense goes through him tonight, Dick. The Cowboys should be looking at a tough fight tonight, Dick. What have they got to do to win this thing?
They've got to stick to their game plan and focus on these keys. First, don't let the other team dictate the tempo and the pace. Play at your speed, baby. Second of all, keep the mental mistakes to a minimum. Turnovers could be the story of this one, baby. And lastly, execute defensively. Don't get caught going for the big steals or the big blocks.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Executes the baby hook.
Vitale, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep close position, and the jump hook is so effective. Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
For the bucket.
Vitale does a great job getting post position. Hey, Brad, that shot's impossible to stop. It's unbelievable. It's not utilized enough. Vitale, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. He gets that one to fall. On the outside, on the dribble, gives it up. And up, he keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. They look to get it to the inside. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Number five fakes the shot. Whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Perfectly executed.
Look at this effort!
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Shoots. He gets another shot off and in.
Hey, this show's about to start, Brad.
Takes the pass in the paint. He unloads a three. He shows the sweet touch. This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love him.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
Dickie's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
To the charity stripe. Hits the first shot. Both free throws go. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's tied to the ball with his deck. Where's he going?
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Dumps it in. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Up. Easy one. The ball handler might be in trouble here. From 3-point land. He nails the bucket.
Trying to go inside.
Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Here's a double team.
Great screen set up, but the shot won't go.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Ole Miss have gotten themselves into a bit of a rhythm on offense, Dick. They're really on a nice run right here. Moving it around the perimeter. Gave it up. He dials long distance. Makes the shot. Looking for a good shot. Webster receives the ball. Now they'll bring it up.
Steele, go up the other way. Get a layup.
A three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Nessler with Vic Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Trying to feed inside. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Lockhart receives the pass. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Up for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it from where you are, but I can hear it clearly. The coach is stressing to his team, go inside, go inside. They've been effective in this area all night long. What an asset to have.
Aaron's right about that.
I tell you, Aaron's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Kicks it out. They work it around the arc. Turnover. Tries for two. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
Gave it up. Thinks about the shot.
Double team now, bad angle.
Looking for the foul. Dribble, gives it up in the paint. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
In the top of the circle.
Look at a shot blocker. Got some contact. Nice hops.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. Pass down low. There's a drop step and, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
Two, perfectly executed.
Replay is queued up. Let's watch it again.
Goes up for two. Easy one. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The shooting guard handles the pass. Knocks it down. Move it around. Broncos have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
That he's on fire.
He uses the shot fake. Pump fakes with a jump hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
The skip pass is picked off. The student body is rocking tonight.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
He shoots from downtown. He drains it. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Tries a three. Goes in.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two, and he scores despite the hack.
He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
At the free throw line. Opportunity. He hits the first. There's a bad pass right to the defender. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Leans in. He puts it in with contact and all. The shooting guard handles the feed. Boy, terrible execution on offense. And a slam. Takes the pass in the paint with a little baby hook.
I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. Puts up the tray. Got it. Looking for a good shot. He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. Basket's good and the foul.
That's a big play. He was there when he needed it, baby.
Look at him now, Dick, celebrating with the cheerleaders. Now that's a spectacle.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders, that's awesome, Brad.
He goes to the line for the first time. He gets it to go.
Pressure on the ball, head on the ball.
Fakes a jumper. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Top of the circle, way off target. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
Looks at the three. It sticks. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, there is a sense of concern on the bench right now. The coaching staff fears if the other players don't get involved soon, it may be too late. He keeps stressing to his team, I can't do this by myself, so help me out. We'll have to continue to monitor this one, guys, along the way.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Perimeter. Count that as a personal foul. Picked off. Goes out of bounds. Oh, and look at the crowd and look at the reaction.
I did the whole fans are going crazy. There's jubilation. Up and inside.
The center takes the pass in the paint. The ball goes out of play. Attempts the three. Oklahoma State are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together.
Yeah, they're really starting to clip on offense.
Takes away the pass. Now the high screen. Goes up for two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby. Look at that spacing.
Picked out of the air. Samuel is feeling good.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you should be afraid to show your emotions. Not getting enough motion on offense. Here they are in transition, Brad.
When I think of home court advantage, this is what I see and this is what I hear. The crowd's fired up, and I'm sure the team is too. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
On the outside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Defensive
play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Perfectly executed. Entry pass in the paint. Trying to draw the foul.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Working it around the perimeter, fakes the shot. And the ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Picks off the lazy pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps.
That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane, anticipating really well.
Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. There's the pick. Perfectly executed. Nice move with a face-up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brown. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Harm and foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
That silly foul right there. But look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Outside. He fires it up. The Cowboys have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Gave it up. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal him off.
He shoots from the top of the circle. He launched that from the parking lot.
Check him out, Brad. I tell you, terrific shot. Really impossible to get a piece of that baby.
Control of the ball. He tries the three. That was nice. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They're working around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint.
There's the trap.
Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
A terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Intercepted. That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
These boys are slinging threes left and right, left, right, down the center every play.
Hey, they're going in from everywhere, baby.
Picks off the pass. Shot clock is dead. Steals a pass.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Puts it up, looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. The rim and no good. At the half, the Rebels are down by 20. Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Defense! Oklahoma State was showing some deadly accuracy from the field in the first half.
Hey, for sure, Brad. This kind of accuracy can easily be carried over to the second half if they continue to be patient with the lock. Patience and poise usually equals points.
Second half, Dick, our focus player update, and what's he got to focus on, or what do his teammates have to focus on?
I think his teammates got to set him up somehow. They got to run some sets to get him free for some good shots.
Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They work the perimeter. Reese is being praised by the crowd. What a great reception.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
Strips the ball. And numbers go the other way. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
The Cowboys are up by 24. Draw some contact. Jackson makes the finger roll. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from long range. He gets the bucket. Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
This place is rocking and rolling, baby.
Launches away. He buries the shot. The Cowboys are ahead by 22. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
Reese receives the ball. Ain't no stopping them right now from the arc, Dick.
You better believe it, baby. They're making them pay from out there.
Here's a double team. Steal. Shoots it. Buried it. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
There's a double team waiting there. On the dribble, gives it up from beyond the arc. Oh, yes.
That's worth another look. Double team now, bad angle.
Taken away. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Done a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Got the shot if he wants it. He gets it to fall. They come with a double team to stop it. Good job defensively. Up fake. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. That's an 8-zip run. Up and inside.
In the paint. Time to pick up the defense here now. That's good. For the bucket, perfectly executed. Look at these fans. They're loving it.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory. Like a six-man.
Makes the block. Him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
The Cowboys have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
The Cowboys have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brian.
Pick and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
There's the fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
College basketball is special to me for that reason right there.
Hey, pandemonium is in full effect.
To get the D to bite. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
That's a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake, and good footwork keeping his pivot foot down.
He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Good job defensively. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
You betcha. He's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I think doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the long pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away. He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Jumps in, and he scores despite the hat. Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. Two, perfectly executed. He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. He goes for three, drains the shot. And a momentary look from three-point land.
That was a high post screen, goes to the lane.
He went for the steal in the post and he missed it there.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing, what a poor job defensively, he gambled.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. The Rebels have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
Unloads a three. He drains the bucket. I think they're trying to make a statement. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. With a bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
The Rebels trail by 33. They work it around the perimeter. On the dribble, gives it up. Looking for contact. When you're talking about the Big 12, people often mention Texas, Kansas, Oklahoma.
Yeah, Brad, they do. But it'll be interesting to see how or if the recent coaching changes will affect the style of play that the Big 12 is known for.
Looking for a good shot. Jumped in front to take it away.
Up and inside.
On the outside. Here's the three ball.
The romp is on, baby. This one's gotten ugly.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
For the deuce. Dickey simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Very slim. We'll continue to monitor his performance the rest of the way, Brad.
He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers.
He launches the bomb. He gets that one to fall. Intercepts it. They work the perimeter. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Goes to the line. Misses the first shot. Second shot, good.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Takes away the pass. Here they come on the break. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Sinks the shot.
This replay is going to be an encore presentation everywhere.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play out there and you're fronting. Great defensive play. Anticipating well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. Scorches the net.
You gotta let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's gonna be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. Gave it up. And the fadeaway jumper, look at that follow through. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Got some room. Let's it fly. He gets the bucket to fall. The Rebels are behind by 35. Off the lazy pass with a deep pass, hammers it down. And the fans here are loving the action.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nestler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand. That's an 8-0 run.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Gave it up. Lockhart. Well, he gets the bucket to drop and gets the foul.
He felt the pressure on the way up, but managed to keep himself focused on the rim.
At the free throw line. He gets it to go.
That's an 11-0 run.
Let's get back to the action. From outside. He gets it to go. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
Tries for two. Perfectly executed.
This is what posters are made from.
On the dribble, gives it up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the outside. The power forward with the ball. He shoots from the top of the circle. He drains the long-range bomb. Picked off. Comes back out from the post.
Out there, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. High post screen, going to use it?
There was no doubt about that one. That's one of the things I absolutely love about college basketball, Dick, the atmosphere.
My goodness, it's chaotic in here.
Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. Fires away. It's good.
That one's definitely worth a second look, Brad.
trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
He looks for three. They're making a living right now at the three-point line.
Let's see if they can keep this up for the remainder of the game.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Look at that spacing.
Here's a double team. Definitely a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He goes to the line, shooting two. Gets his first. He sinks it. The inside goes up for two. Perfectly executed. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, really a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
Intercepted. Like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Now they work it around the perimeter. 10 seconds to put up a shot. He draws a foul. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Now this is home court advantage at its best. The crowd, the students, everyone is feeling good.
Basketball
stolen away. Shot clock is dead. Looking for a good shot. Working it around the perimeter. Too much. That's a foul. How's the front court productivity tonight, Dick?
You know, Brad, basketball is a big man's game. If you have a few on your team and are active and energetic, it makes your team that much better. Ultimately, you want all of your players to be productive, but an inside presence will separate your team from others.
Was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. Dick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he really responded to the challenge, and that led them to the winner's circle.
Oklahoma State takes a huge win by a large margin tonight.
After a game like that, it's hard to believe that these two teams were close in the standings.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.